In this movie, we'll be looking at a company that makes checkers and chess sets. And as usual, their question will be, what strategy that do they need to follow in order to maximize their profit? They have a limit of 1,900 boards available daily, and of course the two games use the same kind of playing board. They have an 80,000 unit limit on how much wood is available daily. We have data on how many pieces of wood each checker set requires and how many pieces each chess set requires. There's a distributor that sells the sets, and the distributor has a limit on how many checker sets and how many chess sets they're willing to take each day. The company knows how profitable the two games are. And so the question, as usual, is how many sets of each type should they make in order to maximize their profit, and what would that maximum profit be? We'll let X represent the number of checker sets they make daily, and Y the number of chess sets. The board constraint, if you go back and read the problem carefully, is that they have a limit of 1,900 boards available daily, so that means the number of games they make, checker sets plus chess sets, cannot exceed that limit. Their wood constraint is 20 units of wood for each checker set, 80 units of wood for each chess set, and that total amount of wood they use cannot exceed their daily supply on units of wood. The distributor will not handle more than 1,250 checker sets daily, nor more than 750 chess sets daily. And as usual, we're constrained to non-negative values. Negative values don't make sense in this problem or in most other problems. When we start graphing the constraints, we find that the board constraint gives us the brown line shown here. And if you check to see where the solution region for the inequality lies, it's the points on or to the left of that brown line. The wood constraint, when you graph the line 20x plus 80y equals 80,000, you get the red line shown here. And again, the solution region for that second inequality is the half plane that contains the origin. We have the two distributor constraints, the one shown in green, x less than or equal to 1250, the corresponding line x equals 1250 is the green line, and for the second distributor constraint, the line y equals 750 is the blue line. So we have those four constraint lines, and in every case the solution region is the points on the side of the line that does include the origin. And once you put that together with the requirement that we be in the first quadrant, the solution region is this little piece of the picture down in here, almost rectangular but not quite. Here I've painted it blue. Now the reason I've chosen this example is because this graph gets very busy in the top right hand corner. And this example illustrates how very, very careful you need to be with your graphing in some instances. When you start work on a problem, you have no way of knowing how precise your graph will need to be. But in this instance, it needs to be very precise. We have the two obvious corner points, the origin and the one on the y-axis and the one on the x-axis. But we also, up in this top right-hand corner, we have one corner point where the blue line and the red line cross. We have another corner point where the brown line and the green line cross. And we also have one right in here where the red line and the brown line cross. So altogether, we're going to have these three corner points plus the three that are all near the top right-hand corner for a total of six corner points. When we set up our table of corner points, if you go through the arithmetic to solve for where all those pairs of lines cross to get the coordinates of the six corner points, this is the list of corner points you should come out with. The 0, 0 corner point obviously is the one down here. X 1250 and Y 0 is this corner point. X 0 and Y 750 is the one over here. And the other three, you have to almost solve the pair of lines and match up as you go along. Among the other three, I believe 1250, 650. See, the X value for this bottom corner point is a little less than the Y value for this bottom corner point is a little less than the Y value for the two above it. So this corner point would be lower than these two. So the 1250, 650, I believe, is the coordinates for the corner point where the green and brown lines intersect. 1200, 700, those are the coordinates of the corner point where the red and the brown line intersect. And I believe the 1000, 750 are the coordinates of the corner point where the blue line and the red line intersect. If that's correct, when you eyeball the profit associated with each corner point, after having calculated it, of course, using your profit equation that came from the word problem, because we knew that it was $1 profit on each checker set and $1.25 profit on each chess set. That's part of the information we're given. It appears that the maximum profit occurs at this corner point, the next to bottom one. $2,075 is a little more than the corner points associated with some of the others. So if that's correct, it would indicate that the optimal strategy is to make 1,200 checker sets and 700 chess sets for a total profit of $2,075. But what I would emphasize once again is that the main value of this example is to illustrate for you how careful you have to be with your graphing, because in some instances, if you were not very careful in this problem, likely when you looked at your graph, you wouldn't recognize correctly which pairs of lines you have to solve to find the which systems of equations you have to solve, taking the lines two at a time in order to correctly find the coordinates of all the corner points, which you then need to compare to find your maximum profit.